In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glory
and to the Holy Spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Well, good morning to the few. I think the wind is scared everyone away. As we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, this is called to mind us. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God, mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. The God who teaches that you abide in hearts that are just and true, God, that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling place pleasing to you. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Take the case, my brothers, of someone who has never done a single good act, but claims that he has faith. Will that faith save him? If one of the brothers or one of the sisters is in need of clothes and has not enough food to live on, and one of you says to them, I wish you well, keep yourself warm and eat plenty, without giving them these bare necessities of life, then what good is that? Faith is like that. If good works do not go with it, it is quite dead. This is the way to talk to people of that kind. You say you have faith, and I have good deeds. I will prove to you that I have faith by showing you my good deeds. Now, you prove to me that you have faith without any good deeds to show. You believe in the one God. That is creditable enough, but the demons have the same belief, and they tremble with fear. Do realize, you senseless man, that faith without good deeds is useless. You surely know that Abraham, our father, was justified by his deed, because he offered his son Isaac on the altar. There you see it, faith and deeds were working together. His faith became perfect by what he did. This is what scripture really means when it says, Abraham put his faith in God, and this was counted as making him justified. And that is why he was called the friend of God. You see now that it is by doing something good, and not only by believing, that a man is justified. A body dies when it is separated from the spirit. And in the same way, faith is dead if it is separated from good deeds. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Happy the man who takes delight in the commands of the Lord.
Happy the man who takes delight in the commands of the Lord.
Happy the man who fears the Lord, who takes delight in his commands. His sons will be powerful on earth. The children of the upright are blessed.
Happy the man who takes delight in the commands of the Lord.
Riches and wealth are in his house. His justice stands firm forever. He is a light in the darkness for the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just.
Happy the man who takes delight in the commands delight in the commands of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. When anyone obeys what Christ has said, God's love comes to perfection in him. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Jesus called people and his disciples to him and said, if anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who wants to save his life will lose it, but anyone who loses his life for my sake and the sake of the gospel will save it. What gain then is it for a man to win the whole world and ruin his life? Indeed, what can man offer in exchange for his life? For if anyone in this adulterous and sinful generation is ashamed of me and my words, the Son of Man will also be ashamed of him. And when he comes in the glory of the Father with his holy angels, and he says to them, I tell you solemnly, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the kingdom of God come with power. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I attended a prayer conference many years ago, and the title of the conference was Be Doers of the Word and Not Hearers Only. Those words came as a direct result of the letter of St. James that we listened to this morning. When we hear the faith and the words are very much part of what we are called to be as a people. Faith without good works is nothing. It's a given debate amongst various Christian denominations over the centuries about how we are justified. Some denominations say we are justified by faith alone. Whatever we do in our lives, don't matter our jobs. It's never been my belief, because my belief has always been that we are indeed saved through our faith and accompanied by good works. To me, it makes common sense that in our Christian lives we are called to show to others the goodness of God through the acts and works that we do. Let us be people of faith, and maybe sometimes that may demand of us that we have to take up the cross and leave our selfish thoughts behind and offer ourselves totally. So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers and petitions this day. We pray for the Church and all of God's holy people, that through faith and good works they may show the love of God to us. Lord, in hearts,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our world and its many needs. We pray for peace, especially at this time when there is tension between East and West. Lord, in our hearts,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who may be affected by the strong winds and gales at this time. We pray that aid may come to those in need. Lord, in our hearts,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick and mind your God, that they may be comforted by the healing presence of Christ. Lord, in our hearts,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died on Moses' anniversaries and Christmas time, that they may be welcomed into the kingdom of God. Lord, in our hearts,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of Heaven, as we pray to you.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever. Blessed are you above all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to all, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of yours, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
May this oblation of the Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward. Through Christ. Amen. Lord, we
and with your spirit,
lift up your
hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is true, right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father, most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through him made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will again for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so the angels and all the saints we acclaim in glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all glories. Make holy this in the lips we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of our blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one.
Blessed St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Amen.
Amen.
The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our prayers, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to share my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since now you have helped us, Lord, to receive you sacramentally, come Holy Spirit to you into their hearts. We graciously give you their liberty, and unite us by the soul in you. Never permit us to be separated from you.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.